UK Driving Theory Test 4.
Question 1. All your passengers must wear a seatbelt unless
they are exempted for medical reasons. You are driving in a congestion area. An infant is sitting on their lap. They are sitting in the back seat.
Answer.
They are exempted for medical reasons.
Question 2. What does the 2-second rule allow you to do?
Check all of your mirrors. Check over your shoulder. Keep a safe distance away from the vehicle in front. Keep a safe distance away from the curb.
Answer.
Keep a safe distance away from the vehicle in front.
Question 3. What is the purpose of an active traffic management scheme on a motorway?
To prevent dangerous overtaking. To reduce the incidence of tailgating. To encourage drivers to make more rest stops. To prevent congestion.
Answer.
To prevent congestion.
Question 4. You are the first car in a queue waiting to turn right into a side street. You need to check your right mirror before you start to move. Why is this?
To make sure that there is no traffic in the side road. To look for pedestrians. To look for traffic that may be emerging. To check if there is any vehicle overtaking you.
Answer.
To check if there is any vehicle overtaking you.
Question 5. You are driving at night when an oncoming car dazzles you with its headlights. What should you do?
Speed up so that you can get past it. Slow down, and maybe stop. Brake hard. Flash your headlights at the other driver.
Answer.
Slow down, and maybe stop.
Question 6. You want to reverse but you are not 100% certain that it is safe to do so. What should you do?
Reverse very slowly. Wind the window down and shout out of the window for anyone to move for you. Get out of your car and check. Sound your horn to alert anyone in your way that you are about to reverse.
Answer.
Get out of your car and check.
Question 7. You discover that your fuel consumption is higher than it should be. What is the most likely cause of this?
Braking too aggressively. Steering too sharply. Using high gears. Driving over 50 miles per hour.
Answer.
Driving over 50 miles per hour.
Question 8. When you drive at night, which glasses should you not wear?
Designer. Bifocals. Half moon. Tinted.
Answer.
Tinted.
Question 9. You are driving at 60 km/h when a pedestrian steps out in front of you and you hit him. Her with the car. The result is.
It is probable that she, him will survive. It is certain that she, him will survive. It is probable that she, him will be killed. It is certain that she, him will be killed.
Answer.
It is probable that she, him will be killed.
Question 10. You have been invited for lunch in a pub but you know that you will be driving in the evening. What should you do?
Have no alcoholic drinks. Have a hot meal with your alcoholic drinks. Drink a pint of water before you have any alcoholic drinks. Only have a couple of alcoholic drinks.
Answer.
Have no alcoholic drinks.
Question 11. You are driving in very heavy rain when suddenly your car starts to slide. This is called
aquaplaning, floating, slipstreaming, water skiing.
Answer.
Aquaplaning.
Question 12. On what occasion should you use your hazard lights?
If you have parked in a spot that isn't allowed. If you have to drive slowly because the weather is bad. When you have no choice but to cause an obstruction. If you are being towed.
Answer.
When you have no choice but to cause an obstruction.
Question 13. There is an obstruction on your side of the road. You should
carry on driving because you have right of way. Stop and give way to oncoming traffic because they have right of way. Accelerate. This is one of those instances where the first through has right of way. Drive through slowly because whoever is there first has right of way, but you do not want to drive dangerously.
Answer.
Stop and give way to oncoming traffic because they have right of way.
Question 14. You notice that there are pedestrians waiting on the pavement at a zebra crossing. It is obvious that they are waiting to cross. What should you do?
Stop on the zebra lines showing your intention to proceed. Ignore them because they haven't stepped onto the zebra crossing yet. Stop so that they can cross while waiting patiently. Speed up so you can get past the zebra crossing so that they can cross when you have gone.
Answer.
Stop so that they can cross while waiting patiently.
Question 15. Under what circumstances are you allowed to drive over a footpath?
When you want to overtake slow-moving traffic. When you want to get lawful access to a property. When there are no pedestrians on it. When it is wide enough for you to do so.
Answer.
When you want to get lawful access to a property.
Question 16. You are driving behind a learner driver when you come to traffic lights that are on red. When they change to green, the learner driver stalls. What should you do?
You should be patient and give them time to move off. Sound your horn and flash your headlights. The sooner they learn what it's really like on the roads, the better. Open your window and shout instructions in order to help. Overtake them. They will be embarrassed and not want you to be there.
Answer.
You should be patient and give them time to move off.
Question 17. What action can you take to slow down more by using the engine?
Put your car into neutral. Put your car into reverse. Change into a lower gear. Change into a higher gear.
Answer.
Change into a lower gear.
Question 18. You are attempting to join a dual carriage way. You should
stop in the same way as you would at a T-junction until it is safe for you to join the dual carriageway. Give way to traffic already on the dual carriageway. Drive straight onto the dual carriageway, the other drivers will see you and give way to you. Drive along the hard shoulder until there is a gap in the traffic.
Answer.
Give way to traffic already on the dual carriageway.
Question 19. You come across an unmarked crossroads and there is also other traffic approaching it. Who has right of way?
The driver who is on the widest road. Whoever is driving the biggest vehicle. Whoever is driving the fastest vehicle. No one.
Answer.
No one.
Question 20. You are allowed to use fog lights when?
When visibility is seriously impaired. Only when it is completely dark. Anytime you like. As soon as dusk arrives.
Answer.
When visibility is seriously impaired.
Question 21. What can you expect to see on a triangular road sign?
Information. Directions. Warnings. Instructions.
Answer.
Warnings.
Question 22. You signal your intentions by your direction indicators and
your anterior light, your brake lights, your fog lights, your side lights.
Answer.
Your brake lights.
Question 23. You are driving in icy conditions when you suddenly go into a rear wheel skid. What should you do?
Don't steer at all and let your car right itself. Steer into the skid. Brake hard. Steer away from the skid.
Answer.
Steer into the skid.
Question 24. You are driving along a single track road when it becomes obvious that the car behind you wants to overtake. You should
stop in a passing place on the right-hand side so that the driver can get past you. Pull into a passing place on your left, or wait opposite a passing place on your right. Put your hand out of the window and gesticulate to tell the driver that overtaking is not possible. Speed up so that the driver behind you will be happier.
Answer.
Pull into a passing place on your left, or wait opposite a passing place on your right.
Question 25. You should not reverse
into a side street for longer than you need to, for longer than the length of your car, in an area that is built up.
Answer.
For longer than you need to.
Question 26. You are involved with a collision where someone suffers a burn. What is the shortest time that a burn should be cooled for?
30 minutes. 20 minutes. 10 minutes. 5 minutes.
Answer.
10 minutes.
Question 27. You are driving on a three-lane motorway. Which lane should you normally drive in?
Any lane that you like. The middle lane. The right-hand lane. The left-hand lane.
Answer.
The left-hand lane.
Question 28. The warning light for your anti-lock brakes comes on and stays on. You should
make sure that the handbrake is fully released. Check the brake fluid. Get your brakes checked straight away. Make sure that the foot brake is released properly by pumping it.
Answer.
Get your brakes checked straight away.
Question 29. You are driving at the speed limit when it becomes clear that the driver behind wants to overtake. What should you do?
Speed up to close the gap between you and the car in front so that the driver behind has no space to move into. Slow down in order to show the driver that you are not happy. Wave the driver on when it is safe to overtake. Stay at the same speed so that the driver can overtake.
Answer.
Stay at the same speed so that the driver can overtake.
Question 30. If you are reversing, who has the most chance of not being seen by you?
Pedestrians. Pedal cyclists. Children. Motorcyclists.
Answer.
Children.
Question 31. Your front and rear fog lights should be
never used in built-out areas. Only used if visibility is greatly impaired. Only ever used if it is foggy at night time. Never used in the daytime.
Answer.
Only used if visibility is greatly impaired.
Question 32. It is compulsory to wear glasses or contact lenses when you are driving if
there is a problem with eyesight in your family. You are unable to read a vehicle number plate from a distance of 120 feet, 36 meters, without them. You are unable to read a vehicle number plate from a distance of 67 feet, 20.5 meters, without them. You have a disabled badge.
Answer.
You are unable to read a vehicle number plate from a distance of 67 feet, 20.5 meters, without them.
Question 33. On what occasion should you use your horn?
To let others know that they have annoyed you. To let others know that you are going straight ahead. To warn others of a danger. As a greeting to other drivers or pedestrians when you recognize them.
Answer.
To warn others of a danger.
Question 34. You are driving along when you come across a cyclist. When you overtake, you should give the cyclist as much room as you would a car. Why is this?
Because the cyclist might want to move into another lane. Because the cyclist might stop and get off. Because the cyclist might want to turn right. Because the cyclist might swerve.
Answer.
Because the cyclist might swerve.
Question 35. You are driving in the left-hand lane of a motorway. Traffic is approaching from the slip lane. You should
race them so that they have to join the motorway behind you. Slow down so that they can join the motorway in front of you. Move into another lane. Keep at the same speed, they will have to wait for you.
Answer.
Move into another lane.
Question 36. You are driving at night along a motorway that is well lit. You must
only use your side lights. Make sure that all your lights are on, including your fog lights. Only use your headlights if there is no more motorway lighting. Always have your headlights on.
Answer.
Always have your headlights on.
Question 37. You need to reverse into a side street. At what point is your car the biggest hazard to passing traffic?
When you have completed the maneuver. As the front of your car swings out. After you have entered the side road. When you begin the maneuver.
Answer.
As the front of your car swings out.
Question 38. You are waiting to come out of a side street into heavy traffic. Which vehicle is the most difficult to see?
A milk float. A lorry. A motorcycle. A tractor.
Answer.
A motorcycle.
Question 39. You are driving down a steep hill and want to go slower. You should
use your handbrake. Put your car into a lower gear. Put your car into neutral. Use your foot brake.
Answer.
Put your car into a lower gear.
Question 40. You are driving in fog. Why should you keep your speed down?
Because the engine will be damp and will need more time to warm up. Because your brakes may not work properly in the damp conditions. Because it is more difficult to see what is going on. Because you might be dazzled by other drivers' fog lights if you drive quickly.
Answer.
Because it is more difficult to see what is going on.
Question 41. What is the purpose of a catalytic converter?
It converts toxic pollutants in exhaust gas to less toxic pollutants. It allows exhaust emissions to be recycled. It reduces the noise from the exhaust system. It makes an exhaust system last longer.
Answer.
It converts toxic pollutants in exhaust gas to less toxic pollutants.
Question 42. You are carrying a heavy load on your roof rack. You should make sure that
you are able to see it through your wing mirrors. It is secured properly. It is covered properly with plastic sheeting. It is loaded so that the most weight is towards the back of the vehicle.
Answer.
It is secured properly.
Question 43. Once you're on a zebra crossing, you should
allow pedestrians to cross but rev your engine so that they will hurry up. Never stop, unless there's immediate danger to pedestrians, cyclists, or other motorists. Stop and wave pedestrians across. Always sound your horn if you see a pedestrian.
Answer.
Never stop, unless there's immediate danger to pedestrians, cyclists, or other motorists.
Question 44. You really need to park, but the only place that you can see is the zigzag lines near to a pedestrian crossing. You are allowed to park here?
Not in rush hour. Between dusk and dawn. Yes, if you are only dropping a passenger off. Never.
Answer.
Never.
Question 45. You are driving and want to use your mobile phone but do not have a hands-free set. This is allowed when?
If you are driving on a quiet road. You are confident that your driving will not be affected. If you have stopped and are not driving. If you are driving on a motorway.
Answer.
If you have stopped and are not driving.
Question 46. One of your passengers is a baby. You are going to place the rear-facing safety seat in the front seat. What must you do first?
Deactivate the front passenger airbag. Make sure the child locks are off. Make sure the child locks are on. Deactivate all the airbags.
Answer.
Deactivate the front passenger airbag.
Question 47. You are driving down a hill when you notice that there is a car parked on the other side of the road, which is causing an obstruction. There are heavy lorries coming up the hill towards you. What should you do?
Slow down and give way to the lorries. Pull over behind the parked car. Keep driving at your normal speed because you have right of way. Speed up so that you can get past as quickly as you can.
Answer.
Slow down and give way to the lorries.
Question 48. Your car is fitted with anti-lock brakes. These will reduce the chances of skidding, particularly when
you need to slow down when you are driving down a steep hill. When the road surface is good. Under normal driving circumstances. You need to brake in an emergency.
Answer.
You need to brake in an emergency.
Question 49. You are driving through slow-moving traffic and you want to change lanes. What must you do before you do so?
Look for motorcycles weaving through the traffic. Sound your horn so that other drivers are aware that you are about to do something. Change into a lower gear. Use hand signals to indicate your intention.
Answer.
Look for motorcycles weaving through the traffic.
Question 50. The hard shoulder of a multi-laned carriageway is for
stopping on if you need to rest. Building up your speed to join the carriageway. Reducing your speed so that you can leave the carriageway. Stopping in an emergency.
Answer.
Stopping in an emergency. Thank you for watching this video and wish you will get your driver license soon.